Well, we're back at Latest Customs, and today we're gonna do a sound system install. You guys have been asking for this a long time, and Rowan offered to do everything today. He said he's gonna do the electronics, everything today. He's gonna install the sound system for you guys today, and he's gonna show you guys step by step how to install a subwoofer with only a monoblock. So today we're gonna be doing the wiring. We're gonna do the subwoofer tuning. The subwoofer install, the box install underneath the seat. It's a little bit tight fit, but we're gonna make it work. And we're gonna start straight up in front. We're gonna first start laying all the wiring in the bucket. And after that, we're gonna start connecting it up. We're gonna check if everything works. And after everything works and everything goes on, we're gonna start tuning the bucket. And then after that, we're gonna start reassembling everything that we removed, including the seat and Tisha's hair, but that's basically about it. Tisha, is you excited for the video? Tisha, is you excited, girl? Nah, you didn't get excited. Nee. Sound system, oh yeah, sound system. Cool. So we're gonna start with the wiring front. So note, we bought this this wiring kit. We bought it at AutoStylus. So with this wiring kit, you get some terminals, and we get the fuse as well. So we have the terminals, we have the power wire, we have the ground wire, we have the RCA leads, and we have a remote wire right there. So we're going to use all of this today. And first off, we're going to start off installing this terminal onto the power wire. So you've been needing one terminal of this I-terminals on your power wire to connect it to the battery. So, and then the ground one, you're going to need another one of this to put on the ground one to ground it onto the chassis of the car. But I'm going to show you guys how to do that real properly, because grounding on these cars are very important. And note, you can't put the power wire with the RCA wire, because then you're going to have that weird interference sound in your ear. That it's like a ground sound. You guys will probably know. Most of the sound guys will probably know. I'll try to get you guys a sample and put it on the video right now, so you guys can hear how it actually sounds when you have a ground interference. But let's start off with the video and start installing this power wire. Cool, so I already cleaned the wire here. So what you're gonna do right now, you're just gonna put the terminal that over the open piece you have right here, and basically we're just gonna try and squeeze it down. After you squeeze on the wires, make sure it's nice and stiff. You guys can see they can't move, and there mustn't be any friction. So just make sure it's nice and tight. And then you do get like silicone stuff you put over here, but I don't usually trust those, because I very much believe in this insulation tape. So I just use this to cover it up. So now that we have everything wired up and we have the terminal on, like I said, you don't want to connect the terminal just yet, because this is the last thing we're going to do. So now we have to seek a way to get this power wire into the chassis of the car, so meaning inside to the driver's side of this bucket. So you guys see this rubber right here? Yes, a rubber, just right there, you guys can see right there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to squeeze this wire through that rubber. Just note, it will say I have to seal up very properly, so don't break it anything. So I'm going to squeeze that through that piece of rubber right there, and I'm going to pull it through on the inside and lay it underneath the mat to where the amplifier will be seated for the rest of its time in this bucket. So let's start it right away. So I don't know if you guys can see that there, but the wire is sticking out right there. So this is the inside of the bucket, or you basically know it's a Nissan. So all I do is I just take it right there. You can see the wire is right there, and you just pull it through until you have enough length of the wire left to connect it to the battery. And still note, we still have to connect the fuse, which will still be in the engine bay. So note, when you pull it through all the way, you still have enough space inside of the engine bay to connect the terminal to the battery, and still have space to put on the fuse. Alright, so you guys can see there, we have enough space to connect it to the battery. We have enough space to put on the fuse, we have enough space to heat this wire inside the engine plate and still to put it on the battery. So we sorted that here. So all you do, you put the terminal on this one side and we go through on with the wiring. So this is the part of the job where you should actually be neat and not be too rough, because if you break some clip or whatsoever, you will have to replace it and that costs extra cash. So we just have to be safe and try to heat the wire very carefully, because I'm a person that don't want to see any wiring in the car, especially when you have a sound system in the car, or as known as the bucket right now. But now the entire goal of doing this, we don't want, like, you have a lot of criminals breaking into cars because they see there's wiring or there's a subwoofer or the speakers in the car or front load or whatever is in the car. So what we're trying to do right now is that we're trying to hit everything so that you won't even know there is a sound system or a subwoofer under the seat. So we're hitting everything the best we could, and as which Ruan is doing at the moment. So I'm going to try and hit every single wire and to get it as neat as possible. As you guys can see right here, we also created like a plank for the monoblock to lay on. And then this side will be the subwoofer with the box. There's minimal space under the seat, but we're going to try and make it work, because Ruan is going to design a plank which is going to go above the subwoofer. Because whenever someone's sitting on the seat, it puts pressure onto the subwoofer. But at the moment, Ruan won't be driving with any passengers, so it will be completely fine for him to drive from my house to his house. So he's heating the wire right now. After this, we're gonna start installing the remote wire from the front loader and installing the ground wire for the monoblock as well. Well, as you can see, the wire is quite long at the moment. So what usually people would do, they would actually cut off the wire right here, but I'm more of a guy that you can actually reuse this wire once again, make his own for one size to scan. This basically this bucket, sorry. And at some point he wants to remove the sound system and put in a new vehicle he's gonna buy. But now the wire is too short because he cut it off right here. And just note, when you putting two wires together and taping them up, you're actually losing the amount of voltage that's pushing through this wire. So the best way is to actually just roll it up and just tape it up, because then you can still reuse the wire on your next vehicle, and there's enough space for the wire to lay around. You can still connect it up and you can still do whatever you want to do with this wire. Cool, so you guys can see that there, it's nice neatly taped up. So all we have to do right now is just heat it basically, which I'm going to do right here, which is a perfect space here to heat it. And there's still enough room to actually connect it up to the place it needs to be. So you just need to clean up a little bit of the silicone around this wire and you can connect it up straight to the amplifier. But I'm just going to leave it right here and we're going to go straight on to the ground wire. Hey, kijk voor voetenbike. No car, huh? Huh? This is what happens now if you... So what we're gonna do right now, we're just gonna put on this terminal right here by the handbrake, because this is a perfect ground and it's very near the amplifier or the monoblock. So just note, to get the perfect ground on your car for your amplifier, just note, you don't want to put it on any of the paint or whatever, you want to put it on pure metal. So the best way is basically just to like take some sanding paper and just to sand up a little bit of the paint and then putting on the terminal right there and screwing it on right there. You can actually make your own hole for your ground as well, but because here's already one here by the handbrake and it's already like there's no paint on here, so the best way is to probably just to put it on here, and it's very very near the amplifier because the amplifier is just here. Which was actually nice about the wiring kit, they actually gave this two terminals right here. They only gave two, I don't know why they didn't give three, but there's two I'm going to use for the power and the ground wire for the amplifier, because it looks very neat and the chances of friction on this amplifier is very very less, because it won't be like the wire won't be just touching the amplifier, because if you connect it to this and you tape it up properly and it's nice and tight and you put it to the amplifier, that's pure power at the end, pure ground. So you won't have any problems and it will look like it's neat if you show it to anybody. So I'm just going to connect these terminals up to the monoblock right here and to the wires. Of course at the moment we already have everything wired up and we have both terminals on. So I'm just going to connect this to the ground and this one to the power. And Roman's really busy laying the ground, sorry not the ground, the RCA's and the remote wire. So after he's done laying that, we can connect it up to the tape and we can connect it up to this monoblock right here. And after this we're going to connect up the subwoofer and we're going to test everything before we start reassembling everything. Always best to use proper wires when connecting up a subwoofer, especially a DVC. So there's a lot of ways to connect up a DVC sub. You can connect it on 2 ohm, 1 ohm, 4 ohm, but at this moment I think I'm going to connect it up 4 ohm, which I'm going to do. This is a negative terminal, this is a negative terminal right here, and I'm going to put a positive terminal on the other side, and I'm just going to connect it up this side, which is going to bridge the positive and the negative on the one side, and then the other side the negative will be going out and the positive will be going out to the amplifier. So Ruan actually bought two positives, one red one and one blue one, but we're still gonna make it work. So I'm gonna put this one positive on the negative, but now I first have to squeeze it a bit up so you can sit a bit tighter so it won't slip out again like that. And the other one I'll just put on the positive the side. So while Ruan will be screwing in the screws to tighten the subwoofer. Ruan, this thing must be straight, man. Make this thing straight here, the sub straight to be here, man. Can't be a skeeve sub here.
It's on the old gate.
No, man. Make it straight, brother. Make it straight. So, he's gonna screw in the sub right there. And then while it's busy like there, I'm gonna stand here with Jody. Come on phone. Fuck off this side.
I firmly focus on
Nah, it's just annoying. Well, I'm gonna stand here with Jody. Just chilling it out. Casually.
Chilling it out.
With his scooter bikes.
You gotta an accent.
So let me take one to listen to. So what we have right here, this is the plug for the backside of the front loader, or more known as the radio. So note, usually the remote wire on this plug, or this is an aftermarket plug, will be the blue one, the blue wire with the white striping. This will normally be the remote wire. If you guys are very uncertain about which color is your remote wire, you guys can always put in the type of front loader radio you have into Google. You guys can just ask Google basically which one is your remote wire, or you just can check your manual which you got in the box or the packaging of the radio. So I'm gonna nick this one up to this yellow wire, because this yellow wire will be going to the monoblock. So I'm gonna nick it up right here. You guys can see right there. So I'm gonna nick it up right there. I'm just gonna strip this just to get the wire and connect it up and insulation tape, or just basically cover it again, and then this RCA leads will be going at the back of the front loader. The front loader usually has like 4 RCA's, but unfortunately this one only has 2. So this one usually just has 2 for like whatever sounds you're putting through there, but normal radios, or the latest radios, have 4 RCA inputs, which you have these two, and you have basically 2 black ones, which the 2 black ones are usually for the subwoofer. Then you have the subwoofer tunings on your radio and your front loader, which you can tune it to, or basically fine tune it whichever way you would like it. So I'm just going to connect this wire up right here. There's very minimal space inside this bucky to actually film. I'm going to connect it up right now, but I'm just going to connect it up and I'm going to show you guys the end result whenever I'm, or basically when I'm done putting up this wire, connecting the RCA's and putting the tape, just to like keep it there for a while, just to check if everything works. So I have the wire taped up, I have it connected. So I'm just gonna plug this at the back of the tape, plug the RCA's in as well, and I'm just gonna leave the tape right here just to make sure that everything works. And we still need to connect up the fuse, still need to connect up the RCA's and the remote wire to the amplifier, and we still need to connect up the subwoofer to the amplifier's wire and install the box. So install, basically put on the power wire. So there's still 6 things I have to do, which I'm gonna do. Which thing I'm gonna do after this, I'm just gonna connect up the RCA's and the remote wire to the amplifier. Then I'm gonna connect up the fuse and I'm gonna connect up the subwoofer. Cool, so I already taped up this remote wire right here. I taped up the RCA's as well. So all I have to do right now is I have to connect it up to the amplifier, connect up the fuse, and this amplifier should go on. And if it goes on, we can proceed installing the subwoofer and laying the wiring for the subwoofer and start shooting some bass. Well, there we have everything connected right there. We have the power wire on, we have the remote wire on, we have the ground wire on, and we have Trixie in the pocket as well. Hello, Trixie. Anyways, and then we have the RCA's plugged in. There are 4 RCA's inputs, so I'm just gonna double check which one we will be using. But I think I might be bridging it or just putting it on one of the channels. Not sure how this monoblock works, but I'm sure I'm gonna figure it out. And then I know Jody, this was previously Jody's amplifier, so Jody just needs to give Rowan the bass controller, and just install the bass controller, so Rowan will be controlling the bass in front, how he wants his girlfriend's dolly key to draw or not to draw that much. That's very much up to him. Rowan?
Yeah.
I've seen it, yeah, okay. So what we're gonna do right now, we're gonna install the fuse. So first you need to do, you first need to cut off the wire, and you need to strip both of them. Cool, so I already stripped this part of the wire as well as the other part. So I'm just gonna show you guys the one side, how to connect up the one side. So usually you will be needing an Allen key for this one right here. So first you will be installing this thing over here. You install this first because that's the holder for the fuse. Then you obviously install this because this will be like the rubber for the fuse. And then you just put this one in right here. And I'll be needing which Allen key? Sure. And there we go. There we go. So basically that's a perfect way how to connect up the fuse. So I'm just gonna do the other side as well. Well, so I have the fuse connected up and we just need to do put this terminal onto the battery. So that will be basically about it. Feel like we will. Cool, so it's time to test the amplifier or the monoblock. You're just gonna put on the tape, please. Yeah, just put in the. Is there any light on that side?
Yeah, power on.
Let me just check that side. You see? There we go. You guys can see right there, the light is on. That's the green light right there. The red light is for protection mode if something goes wrong. So you guys can see the amplifier is on and it was a job well done first time. So now it's just time to install the subwoofer. So the wiring was too short and we just like extended it just to like basically test it out, because it's a lot of effort just removing the subwoofer to put in a long wire. So we basically just extended it for the time being, and we got the negative and the positive. So what I'm going to do right now is that I'm going to connect it to the negative and the positive on the one side, and we're going to see basically how the subwoofer plays and how it performs. Great, so now that everything is in, it's time to basically test out how the subwoofer plays. The last time I tested it inside the box with my 8-inch subwoofer, it didn't play that great because that was like a card type subwoofer, because it was a very big magnet. But this is a slim fit subwoofer and it doesn't need as big, it doesn't need a big box to basically to perform. So basically this box is actually perfect for the subwoofer, even a smaller box. So the volume of the box basically complements the subwoofer, and it helps it to perform the way it should. So it's basically just hope for the best. Khalifa. This is an everyday thing at Late Late Customs. No shiz. No shiz. Kom maar, Roan, wat is dit ding maak, man? Speel hij bij jezelf oors. Nah, dat is maar echt really one neat bakkie. So, me and Roan, we're done installing the sound system and you guys know everything step by step. I didn't show you guys the tuning board because every sub differs and every monoblock or amplifier differs and how you have to tune it according to the sub. Just note, whenever you're tuning your subwoofer, you have to tune it basically according to your box. So, you tune your amplifier according to what your sub can hold and what the box can hold. But this was a total success. First try the amplifier went on. Usually there's a few problems that occurs, but we did everything correct. You guys would know how to do your own sound system after watching this video. I'm really grateful for you guys really supporting me, and I know a lot of you guys wanted me to make this video a long time ago, and I didn't really have chance to actually make this video until this day, which Ruan really wanted the sound system in his car, and I thought, okay, cool, why not, and just make a video for you guys. So now you guys know how to install a sound system. If you guys still struggling to install your sound system, or you guys would like me to install your sound system, I do install sound system by cost. So you guys can just contact me on Instagram. I'll leave my Instagram right here below, and you guys can contact me on Instagram regarding your sound system. And if you guys would like any advice, you guys can contact me. Please don't WhatsApp me because my WhatsApp messages are so full and I don't get chance to reply to any of you guys. So just send me a message on Instagram and I will give you a instant response as quick as possible. So guys, I'm really grateful for your guys' support, and we're done with the caddy. So, or the basically not the caddy, with the champ bucky or the deluxe bucky or whatever you call this Nissan bucky. So we're done with the bucky now, and it was a total success. Ruan is happy, I'm happy, and everything worked out amazing. So I'm grateful for you guys watching this video. Please go and smash that like button, and please don't forget to subscribe, because I've watched the stats, and basically 80% of you guys watching my videos are not subscribed. How can't you be subscribed? You have to subscribe to my channel, because there are still amazing content coming, especially of this VT gear back. And one hour, that's Late Late Customs with me. Late Late Customs, we out. Thank you.